Samsung's new Galaxy Note 7 smartphone features some of the world's most advanced biometric authentication technology. And while the iris scanner in the Note 7 does feel a bit like something from a cool sci-fi flick, and it can be convenient, the overall experience leaves much to be desired. Here's how it all works, and where it falls short. The Note 7 uses a dedicated infrared LED and iris camera to capture and scan digital images of the colored area around your pupil. The Note 7 then stores your biometric iris information in a secure element on the phone, and it never leaves that space, according to Samsung. Iris patterns are almost impossible to replicate, so the tech is among the most secure authentication systems available, Samsung says. Sounds impressive so far, right? But the biggest problem with the Note 7 iris scanner, it's just not reliable. It works very well in certain environments, but not at all in others. For example, if you walk outside on a bright sunny day, the iris scanner won't work due to glare and screen reflection. If you wear contact lenses or glasses, especially sunglasses, you'll have issues in even ideal conditions. The Note 7 iris feature also doesn't get along well with screen protectors, which can obstruct the scanner. You have to wake the device, then tap a button to invoke the iris scanner, so it actually takes longer to unlock your phone with an iris than a fingerprint. Thankfully, you can use both an iris and a finger to unlock the Note 7, so you don't have to choose only one option. Oh, and the on-screen images of your face and eyes during the scan process kinda make you look like a terrified alien. And maybe that's just me. The Note 7 is only the second device from Samsung to feature an iris scanner, so it's no surprise that the technology isn't perfect. And it is more secure than using a password or even your fingerprint, according to Samsung. So while the iris scanner in the Note 7 may feel like more of a novelty at this point than something you really want to rely on, it shows real potential. And I remember feeling exactly the same way about the first fingerprint scanner in a smartphone. Now I can't imagine using a phone without one.